Welcome back to my channel, Teaching and Learning. My name is Chetra, and in this channel, we mainly talk about business communication, IELTS practice, English language learning, and other related professional and academic skills. Today, in this video, I'm going to talk about one of the very important and interesting, let's say it's an issue or problem that is in case of IELTS test. So today's video is going to be about IELTS, problem or IELTS issue with the candidates. So many learners, or let's say many candidates who have done their major English in the universities, or let's say in high school, they often face problems in case of IELTS test. Let me tell you, the students who have completed their 12th grade and after, completing their education, when they face the IELTS test, if they really want to study abroad in United States, Great Britain, Australia, or nowadays in any countries, where the medium of instruction is English. So at that time, either the students, they have just completed their grade 12, or they have completed their bachelor, BA in English, or MA in English. Similarly, it may be, MA in English, or BA in English, or plus 2, 10 plus 2, we often say 12 grade with major English. So even though they have the very high level of confidence, and obviously they have the basic or fundamental knowledge of English language, and they have been practicing as their major subjects, mainly listening, speaking, reading and writing, along with the two aspects of English, vocabularies and grammar. So in one hand, IELTS attempts to test the candidate for his skills, listening, speaking, and reading, writing. Similarly, the students who have done his, BA in English literature or MA in English literature, they have been playing with so many texts. Either some of them are in, movie films, novels, sometimes they perform some of the plays or dramas, and so many things are there. And we can say that the test of IELTS is similar with the course and test of English literature in one hand. But when we go to the, course content of, contents of B.Ed and M.Ed in major English, at that time, four skills are the core area of the study. So after completing B.Ed in English, how can a candidate have just 5.5 or 6 in IELTS? He must have at least more than 7. Because what he has to do in IELTS test, he has already done it in his course of B.Ed or M.Ed in English. But I have seen many students who have not achieved good score in IELTS, even after completing their B.Ed. In B.Ed, the course is ELT, English Language Teaching. The entire, subject matter of this course is 4 skills and 2 aspects. So IELTS actually test nothing more than this, but whenever, even after completing their bachelor degree in English education, a bachelor degree, more particularly, bachelor degree in English language skills and aspects, and when they go for the IELTS test further study in abroad, so they don't have good score. They don't have the score that is supposed to have. So what's the problem? What is the reason behind this? So this is very serious issue. We need to talk about it. We need to carry out some of the researches and studies also in this area. Otherwise, some of the people might blame to the course of B.Ed and M.Ed, whereas some other people might blame to the, nature and pattern of IELTS test. So what should be done in this area? It is a very serious issue. So Let me, make it more clear. The students having arts degree in major English, they do the critical readings, the different genres of literature, history of English language and literature, so many things they do. And those students who have done their master's and bachelor's, this is in a major English, this is the course of IELTS. So they have, after spending about, 4 to 5 years in major English, in the same content, how a candidate can have the low score? Time and again, I'm asking how or why? Because this is the second reason behind this is what I have found. Even though people have to carry out many studies and research on this issue and area, why the non-native speakers, even after completing their degrees in major English, even after completing their, course of their curriculum and after spending many years, how can they have the very low score in IELTS? That's the very serious issue we need to understand over here. And as I have come to the conclusion from my experiences and researches that there are the problem in both areas. In the area of curriculum as well as in the area of IELTS test. In the nature of IELTS is also should be reviewed. And the course of B.Ed and M.Ed major English should be revised to some extent. And what about the teaching learning methodologies? Are they okay with which supports the course content and which are designed for the fulfilling the objectives of the course? So now, in the very basic level, we can say this much only, but so many researches and studies should be carried out and should be done to find out the problems and to address this problem through some of the solutions, so that the students will not have many problems regarding this IELTS test, mainly for the students of B.Ed and M.Ed with major English. And more interesting thing over here is, comparatively, if you go through the research, the students who have done their, majors with science and engineering, so they have very good scores in the IELTS. This is funny, at least. I'm not trying to, convince my viewers about that the students who have done their science and engineering, they don't have the knowledge of English language. I'm not trying to say that. But the problem is, how come the students of science and engineering, have more score or a high score than the students of major English who have done the same course? What is tested in IELTS is learned and taught, as well as tested in the curriculum of in the programs of B.Ed and M.Ed. That's the main issue. So thank you very much for watching this video. I'll come to another video in with another subject matter related to the contemporary issues related to English language, business communication, IELTS, and other academic skills. So please keep watching my channels, and if you have not subscribed yet, please subscribe my channel. And if you have some comments and feedback, why don't you write some comments and feedback so that it can be more interactive, and you will have the better platform where you can practice all these things. Thank you. Have a great time. Thank you.